yes, there is a stigma around psychiatric medications because most people don't know how they work and how long they need to be taken and what side effects there are. And many people believe that once you're on psychiatric medications, you might have to take them lifelong, which is not the case at all. This lifelong kind of myth that has come up is probably because of the fact that many people stop medications in between, especially for the severe conditions, and then later on the condition relapses, and then they again are put on medications. So the treatment duration is again increased, and they might again default and stop medications. So if this goes on, then you'll have to require medication, you know, on a regular basis, which then transforms to a lifelong kind of a belief. There's also a belief that if one is on medications, that the medication is controlling you, which is not the case. It doesn't control you in the sense as you become a slave to the medication. That's not true. The hormone called serotonin, which is called the feel-good hormone of the brain, is deficient in people with depression. Even before we prescribe medications, the body has a way of having the serotonin present in various parts of the brain. And once the serotonin is released from one part, it is then reabsorbed, taken back, released, reabsorbed. So that's the cycle as to how serotonin is maintained in the brain. But in people with depression, the serotonin is deficient and is not available for its actions in the brain. So the medications actually prevent its reuptake and is made more available. So that's as simple as that. So more availability of serotonin means that the mood is much more better and not on the lower side. So only after you are prescribed and you take these medications, you would know how you actually react, whether this medication is going to be effective for you or it's not going to be effective for you. So it depends on a person's internal body makeup and how the drug is metabolized in the body. There might be other social causes also which may kind of interfere with the progress or recovery. If you take the example of depression, and if somebody is given prescriptions for depression and they are taking these medications, let's say for a month, 2 months, and there's no response, there might be a requirement to see if there is something else in this person's life that is contributing to the persistence of depression. Let's say if there is a stressful factor and he or she is not able to cope with it, then we might have to help this person how to deal with that stress. The medications have different mechanisms of actions for different conditions. Say for example, in schizophrenia, we use certain medications which block certain hormones or neurotransmitters in the brain. Whereas for depression, the hormones and the neurotransmitters are different. If you are prescribed a medication for a condition, the doctor is very certain that you will improve with these medications, you will recover with these medications, and that it is important for you to take these medications to eliminate the symptoms of depression or anxiety or psychosis. Most medications prescribed for the various psychiatric conditions do take some time. They don't have immediate action because changes that has to happen at the brain molecular level take some time, and this time is about 2 to 3 weeks. And at the end of 2 to 3 weeks, one can start seeing the response in terms of reduction in symptoms. However, one must always be cautious that in these 2 to 3 weeks, if the symptoms are still acute, if you're still quite, feeling very tense or agitated, or you're not sleeping, then the doctor can prescribe additional supporting medications which can calm you down and which might give you good sleep till the antidepressant takes over. But you must also remember that some of these supporting sleeping medications or medications given for anxiety should not be taken for a long time because you can get addicted to it at some point. Once you start feeling a little more calm and relaxed, then you can ask your doctor if, you know, the supporting medication can be reduced or taken off. It's it's important that you ask your doctor what side effects to expect when you take these medications and what you should do when you have these side effects. One thing to remember is that people are always concerned about these side effects, and they might say that, okay, if I look at the list of side effects, I don't want to take these medications. But they should also know that all these side effects may not occur in that person. Each person's body reacts differently to the medication, and only after one takes the medication you will know whether this side effect is happening in your with you, or it is not happening to you, or whether you are comfortable with this medication. If you see that something is happening and you are, let's say for example, you have gastric problems, or let's say you have a headache, or you're sleeping too much, it's important that you get back to your doctor and find out whether you need to continue or some other medication can be added to change this medication, or something else can be done to reduce the side effect. For depression, the treatment duration is about 6 to 9 months, and if a person starts improving at the end of 2 months, he or she might feel that, okay, I'm improving and I don't have to take these medications any longer, which can then lead to a relapse very quickly. And it's important that duration of treatment is explained much earlier, and the person has to take it for, let's say, 6 to 9 months. And at the end of 6 to 9 months, the doctor will reduce it slowly over a period of time, gradually taper it and stop it. These medicines should not be stopped abruptly on by oneself on their own. However, since you already have had, say, depression or a psychotic episode, there could be a risk of this recurring later. But you can always ask the doctor as to how you can prevent these episodes to happen again, either through changing your lifestyle or maintaining some practices, like say maybe yoga or having a exercise regime. All these are known to prevent further episodes. The combination of medications and therapy work best than either alone. So if one is taking medications and the doctor also feels that you require therapy, and then at some point you might feel that, okay, I'm anyway on therapy, do I have to still take these medications? So it's important to consult with your doctor whether these medications can just be stopped just like that. Because even if you stop the medication and you are on therapy, there's a chance that you might relapse. So it's better to complete the course of treatment so you can have the medications and the benefit of therapy, and you might have a better response than taking either alone.